Okay, so in this video, I'm going to show you how we can find the first, second, third, or nth highest match. We'll do that both in Google Sheets and Excel, and it's actually going to be most likely exactly the same formula. So let's just start here. So first of all, let me explain you what I'm trying to get. So let's say we have this data and we have all of these salespeople. I want to find out, for example, for Isabella, when was the first, the second, or the third, or nth highest sale? To illustrate that, if I just took this data set and sorted it, this is not the way we're going to do that, but this is just explaining you what we're trying to accomplish here. If I just take the header rows and just sort this data first by sales rep, and then add another level and sort it by sales amounts. And I'll do Z to A, highest to lowest for sales amounts, right? So if I sort this data and we scroll down to find Isabella, see, we have all Isabella sales grouped together. And we also sorted her sales amounts. So this is the first highest, then the second highest, and it's gonna keep going. And see, it's decreasing because of the sorting order. And by the time we get to the last number, it's the lowest number. And then we got Jake. So for Isabella, if I was trying to find her second highest sale date, that would be this date right in here. If I wanted to find the first highest one, it would be this one, and so on, right? So that's exactly what we're gonna do. So I'm gonna undo all of this sorting, and we'll do this whole thing with a formula, and we'll do it in a way that we could just list all the salespeople and find when was their highest sale date. So first of all, let's just get a list of our salespeople. So I'll start by doing unique function and just select our salespeople from here. So I need the range of salespeople from here. So I'll just click on the first salesperson, Control Shift down or Command Shift down to select this whole range, close parentheses, hit enter. That should give us a nice list of salespeople. You could sort this if you wanted to by adding sort function around this like that. I'm not actually going to sort this, but if you wanted a sorted list, you could do that too. I'm gonna get rid of that. So now we need to find the highest month for Isabella. So to do that, what I'll do, I'll first filter the data I have on the left to just Isabella. And I'll probably do it right here so it doesn't sit right next to each other, so it's not too confusing. So I'll do filter. And what I'm gonna choose as a range for this filter is this whole data set. So I'll just select from basically A through G, all the columns in my data. Just for good practice, I'll do F4 to make this absolute reference, comma, and then I need what's called a condition in this function. So I want to filter this data to just Isabella right now. So the way I'm gonna do that, after this comma, I'm gonna select this column C that I want filtered by, and I'll do F4 to make it absolute reference, and I'll check if that equals to Isabella, right in here. Close parentheses and hit enter. And what we're gonna get is right here, see, filtered data from this data set on the left, just filtered data that shows Isabella's sales. So now from this data, I want to make sure I have this sorted by the sales amounts to have the highest one on top. And to do that, we'll take this filter function and add sort around it. And sort function will allow us to sort this data. So this is gonna be the data we're trying to sort. I'm gonna go after this parentheses, do a comma. And the column I'll be sorting by, we need to provide the column number. So in this filter data, it's gonna start from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Column number 7 is our sales amounts, right? Comma, and finally, do we want to sort this in ascending order or not? So if you want in ascending order, you'll do true. So let me just show you what it gives you. So I'm going to do true and hit enter. So you'll see how it sorts by these numbers from lowest to highest. We want the exact opposite. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to change this true to false. So we're sorting by column number 7 in descending order. And there we go. We got the highest number on top. So if I wanted to know the date, then it would be this date right here. If I want the first highest one, this would be the date for that. If I want the second highest one, this would be the date for that, and so on. So let's start with the first one. So if I wanted the first highest one, I'll go back. And we want to basically just get this date that's in this grid located in row 1, column 1, right in here. If I wanted this one, that would be row 2, column 1 in this grid. Now, if you wanted to get maybe like the store or something, then you could think about row 1, column 4 or row 2, column 4 or something like that. In this case, I want the date. So it's going to be row 1, column 1 if I want the first one. So what I'll do, I'll go back to this and put this inside of a function index. And index will allow us to do that exact, you know, indexing of our data by giving row and column numbers. So the row is going to be 1. Comma, and the column is also going to be 1. So I'm going to do that, both 1. I'm going to hit enter, and that should be the date. It's not formatted, right? So I would have to change this formatting to a date because this is a date. So that would be the date for the first highest sale. So if I wanted the second one, all I have to do is change the row number to go to the next row down, and that would be this one, 2. And this would be the second highest sale date. And so on. In this case, I'm going to do the first one, and you could obviously change this 3, 4, 5, whatever you want, right? I'm going to do the first one, 1, 1, and that should be the first one for Isabella. I'm going to delete this one for now. And then if I wanted now to get that for everybody else, I could just drag this formula down, and we're going to get the first highest sale date for each salesperson. So let's just check. For example, one of these. Let's say I want to check if this is correct. Olivia 3/30/2018, right? So to do that, again, we need to make sure we sort this data. So again, let's just keep that in mind. 3/30/2018, so March 30th. So I'll take this and sort this data. First by sales rep, and then by sales amount. Highest to lowest. And let's try to find Olivia here. So there it is. See, that's the first one, and that's 3/30/2018, which is accurate. And the second one should be 4/22/2019. So if we go up there and change this to 2 instead of 1, see, that would be 4/22/2019. Again, I'm going to change this back to the first highest. Drag this down. And as you can see, it works. So to do the same thing in Excel, it's going to be pretty much the same formula. So I'm going to just copy this unique function exactly the same way. Go back to Excel and just put this in here someplace. So that's our list of salespeople. I'm going to go back to Google Sheets. Let's get our second formula and see if that works. I'm going to copy that, hit escape, go back to Excel. I'm going to paste it right in here. So we got an error. Let's take a look and see what's going on. Filter should definitely not be our problem. Let's take a look at the sort function. So this sort, let's take a look at their arguments. They have array, sort column, and sort order. So this would be the column. So column is going to be 7. Well, that is not going to change. What is the sort order? Maybe they don't accept false and true. Let's just do a comma here. And it's blocking some of this, but I can see descending. See, it seems to be -1 here. So I'm going to do -1 instead of false And let's try this and see if that works. Seems like we're doing well now. So I'm going to change this to date. There we go. Let's just make sure it's the same thing. So Isabella 10/14/18. So Isabella 10/14/18. Not in the same sorting order as far as the people go, but the data is working the same. Now, apparently in Excel, when you do this sorting order, see right in here, see ascending is 1, descending is -1. In Google Sheets, that would be true or false. So instead of saying false here, we'll just do -1. And that should take care of that. And that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.